Alright, so what is going on, everybody on YouTube? It's your boy Roger99, and I'm back 2 days later trying to film another video. As you guys can see, I'm in my room right now. Today I'm gonna bring you this camera's heavy. My ADD with the battery grip, a mic, and a lens. Shit, heavy. Today I'm gonna try to bring you guys the video I promised you guys on my car. I am gonna take it up to like this one hill where it has a really nice view, or I might just scout for a new spot. I don't really know. We'll find out right now. I'm gonna go get some coffee as well because I haven't drank coffee all day, and it's currently 11 o'clock in the morning, so that is all bad. My arm's getting tired as fuck. I'm just gonna drive up there. I'm gonna give you guys a cold start right now. It doesn't really sound too special. I mean, it sounds better than normal Ecoboost, but I'll give you guys a cold start right now so you guys can hear it. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Just gonna drive up there. I'm gonna give you guys a walk around, probably shoot some pictures for IG. I got the fit on right now, and then that's pretty much it. I'm charging my GoPro to hopefully film some like fucking video of me driving up there. It's like at 50% and I don't have anywhere to put it in the car, so we'll see what happens with that. Let me get all my shit together, the shoes I'm trying to shoot, I already got the fit. Let me get my tripod and give you guys a cold start so you guys can hear what the shit is sounding like. That's pretty much it. Let's see what we get into. Hopefully we don't get pulled over, because that's usually what we get into. Time to go get coffee, load this shit up. I'm done rambling on too much. I'll catch you guys outside. So we're in the whip. I know you could probably hear the AC right now because it is fucking like, what is it outside? A solid 85 at 11 in the morning. Not bad. Just a quick little update. Let me drive up there. Hopefully I can use my GoPro. I found a way to put it in my mouth and bite it. Even though that sounds wrong, but you guys will see when I film it. So yeah, peace out. See you guys in a bit. And yeah, let's go see where I park.
This is a CHUKI beat production. This is a CHUKI beat production.
made it up here to the spot. As you guys can see, I'm up in like the fucking broad daylight. It's all good. Spot is over there. If you guys have seen my photography page, I usually do come here quite often just for fun. Because look at this view. So that's the view. But we're not here for the view. We're here for my car. So it is right here. This white bitch right here. Because, you know, all my cars got to be white. You already know that shit. I know there's going to be hella wind, but it's whatever. So, yeah, this is it. It's this thing right here. As you guys can see, let me just turn the camera around because you guys do not want to see me because the video is about the car. So, it's pretty much a 2019 Ford Mustang EcoBoost. You have the performance package on it. So you do have the spoiler, as you guys can see. Have the spoiler on the back. And it does come with these wheels right here. They're 19-inch performance wheels, performance package wheels. You guys can see right there. So they are different from your basic EcoBoost wheel. It's not the ugly-ass aluminum ones that come in an 18-inch with the fat-ass tire. So these come in a 19-inch with a 35, I believe. A 40 sidewall tire, sportier than the normal stuff. And then on the front, if you guys can see that brake caliper in there, it is a bigger caliper because it is the sport pack. So it comes with I think it's base model GT brakes, which are pretty good for EcoBoost. It's just a white EcoBoost. Really aesthetics on the outside, I really haven't done much. I am gonna buy some lowering springs for it, lower it an inch and a half on the front and an inch and a quarter on the back, so it's going to give it a nice little stance. In terms of mods on the outside, I've only plasti dipped the pony logo. I added this sticker. It's from Washness Media, if you guys don't know him. It's a bomb ass car photographer, like straight up goals. And I plasti dipped the front logo as well, just to black out the whole entire front end. Eventually I want to tint the front, the headlights, and then the side markers and all that shit. I kind of want to get my stance looking good first, because the back and the front wheels do not sit flush. You guys can see they are like tucked in like an inch, so I'm probably gonna do springs all around and then some spacers on the wheels to give it a nice little aggressive muscle stance. So in terms of what I've done to the car so far, it's pretty much on the interior. Dyna Performance on IG makes these carbon fiber overlays and trim overlays for, like, you know, your interior and shit. So I got their carbon fiber, you see it, door handle overlay. As you guys can see, got the carbon fiber on there. And there is a piece in here. You just can't really see it because there's not enough sun. And I got the one that goes on the door itself, whole entire pack. Comes with all this. It's two separate pieces, but it looks sick as fuck if you guys can't see. The carbon just shining on the sun. And as well as, I got the carbon fiber on the steering wheel, as you guys can see, middle with the pony. Right here, it comes with a piece for this part and a piece for these sides right here. It looks pretty nice if you ask me. Just adds a different little touch. I do have the vents grip just because I needed a spot to put my phone. And as well as, I do have the two gauges, one for the oil pressure and one for the boost of the car, as you can see. And just a basic red shift knob. I got this from American Muscle .com for like 25 bucks. And you do have the big LCD screen on the inside. Nothing special, just, you know, your basic Apple CarPlay, shit like that. Mustang logo on the other side. And you do have cloth seats. You can't really see them. They just have Mustang debossed on the bottom, on the top, I mean, with the two stripes running down. And you do have the two rear seats, which I don't really use because no one fits in the back. It's honestly basic as fuck, not really much to it. I didn't want the leather seats. I could have got the leather seats, but I didn't want them because, as you guys can see, shit is hot as fuck outside and there really is no point on me burning my ass every time I get in it or freezing my ass in the winter. So I opted for cloth seats. The only thing, and honestly I just didn't think about it, I kind of regret not getting the 12-inch electronic cluster. I just have no reason why I didn't like get it. I should have probably got it just to like make this whole look, you know, look super sick. I got the basic non-digital one. It works just fine. It's whatever. It's just an EcoBoost. Maybe if I get a 5.0 later down the line, I'll probably get it. For now, that's about it. There really is no much point to this video. Just I wanted to show you there's really nothing done to it. Under the hood, I'll show you guys under the hood. So under the hood, you got your little 2.3 liter turbo. Got the turbo in there. You guys can see a little shiny thing in like the top right rule of thirds. And it does come with the strut tower brace. I don't know if it's part of the performance package or an additional package, but it does come with that. It's pretty much spec'd out in terms of like performance wise for an EcoBoost, not like luxury stuff. That's pretty much the engine bay, nothing too special. The rear is pretty much the exact same as any other Mustang, except I got the spoiler. You guys can see it right there, I got the spoiler. All right, y'all, so pretty much that's the car. Oh, one of the biggest things I forgot to mention, which is like my favorite part. Let me just show you guys real quick. You see those quad tip exhausts? Yep, it has active exhaust, which is why it makes it sound so much better than a basic EcoBoost. That is the main reason why it sounds louder than a, you know, regular EcoBoost. And I really can't find an exhaust to replace this because no EcoBoost exhausts are made with a quad tip. And I don't want to get rid of quad tip exhaust because it looks sick. So I just thought I'd point that out. That's pretty much the whole entire car. It's just stock right now. Like I mentioned, I do want to, in the short term, like in the short run, I want to do lowering springs, wheel spacers to get my wheels out flush on the fenders. And just a couple performance mods under the hood. I do want to do an air intake, an intercooler, a tune. And maybe a downpipe just to get like more airflow. If I can find a quad tip exhaust, I will get a quad tip exhaust. As well as aesthetic wise, I want to do a rear diffuser, a more aggressive one after I lower it. A front lip, a more aggressive one after I lower it. And then eventually get different wheels, like just a wider set of wheels on the back. Probably some 10 and a halfs or 11s. Eventually, like probably in the near future, like in a year, year and a half, 2 years from now, I do want to go air suspension on this shit. So that is my plan. As well as I do need tints, as I'm looking straight through my car right now. It does not have tints at all. So I need to tint that as well. And I'll probably just do like some carbon fiber parts, like a trunk or a hood, and just switch up the look of it, make it more aggressive. Probably dump more money into this than I should because it is an EcoBoost and it's not a 5.0. But my plan for this is make a show car out of it. Not much performance wise, because 5.0 on one of these with full bolt-ons and tune is still going to beat it. So my goal is not to do numbers in terms of power, but just to make it look pretty. And that's it. So I hope you guys enjoy those clips of me driving here. I hit 110 on a 55, I believe. So that's like probably jail and a fucking felony or misdemeanor, whatever they call it. So yeah, that's pretty much it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know I am dark as fuck. Can you guys see me better? Yep. Now the back is blown out, but who cares? So yeah, that is about it. Other than that, it's just a basic EcoBoost Mustang. I don't want to get into like performance wise. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know it's something different, but that's what I told you guys I would bring. And I just thought I'd throw this out there for when I actually do like make some, not install videos, but when I do buy parts and get them installed, you guys are up to date on what I have done to it. That way you guys, it's kind of a progression, you know, just to see where this is going. So let me shoot some IG pics. You guys will probably see this fit on the gram sooner or later. And let me fucking stop rambling on. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hit the thumbs up button. Comment down below what you think of the car. What would you do if you had an EcoBoost Mustang? And as well as subscribe down below. Thank you guys a lot for 1,000 subs. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Follow me on IG at Rogers99 and Rodman Visuals. I'll have it in one of these two corners. I still don't even know which one it is, honestly. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Have a blessed day. Rogers99 signing out. Peace.